Welcome to Sun City News. I'm your host, Noma Taylor, and here are some of the news stories we're covering for you this week. AARP Tax Aid Services are coming to Sun City, and we have the details. We find out about Backpack Buddies and the Box Program's annual fundraiser, Change for Change. Those stories and much more. Sun City News starts now.
From our studios in Pinckney Hall, this is Sun City News with Norma Taylor. Entertainment news with Randy Selman. Sports with Doug Wright. And the entire Sun City News team covering your community and the South Carolina Lowcountry.
AARP Tax Aid Services will be a bit different this year in order to promote COVID-19 safety protocols. Appointments will be required and no walk-ins accepted in an effort to minimize contact. Everyone must take an appointment for service. Here in Sun City, the location and times are Pinckney Hall, Mondays and Thursdays, starting February 15th, 7:30 a.m. to 2 o'clock p.m. The times and dates can vary. Residents are instructed to go to the last doors at the end of the entrance hall, Colleton Room. No taxpayers will be admitted into the rooms. Intake will be done in the doorway. Call 843-603-1632 for an intake appointment. Now, when you make your appointment, you will be told where to pick up an AARP tax envelope and intake forms. You must fill in all forms completely. Remove all tax items from envelopes. Remove all staples. Bring your ID and Social Security card. If you file married filing jointly, both spouses must be present at intake and at the appointment to pick up your return and sign the e-file form. Now, your intake interview will take about 20 minutes. They will scan your documents to a secure site, and then you can leave. After your return is completed by a volunteer, you will receive a call from the quality reviewer within 24 to 48 hours and given a time to pick up your return. During the second appointment, your final return will be printed and you will sign the form telling the tax aid service that they can electronically file it. You will then take your printed return and documents home with you. Now, until all of this is complete, your taxes will not be filed. Face coverings are required at all times. Please bring your own sanitizer and be respectful to maintain a social distance of at least 6 feet from our volunteers. If you are feeling ill in any way on the day of your appointment, please call to reschedule. We do not want to spread infection. Now, with this new model, the tax aid service will not be able to do as many returns, so we are limiting service to simple returns. AARP volunteers look forward to helping our community this year. Our Sun City residents have always answered the call as volunteers who dedicate hours and resources in helping others. One of those groups is Friends of Backpack Buddies 2, the Box Program. Well, ladies, thanks for being on Sun City News. Well, Diane, give us a little history of the group. I know it was started a long time ago in 2015.
Yeah, a bunch of us ladies got together in Fox Lake, and we wanted to do something. We needed to address the hunger issue around us. We started out with a cookbook 1 year and raised some money that mainly went to school nurses to help fund their food closets that they had. And then the next year we tried something new, and we went to a luncheon that people attended. After that, we realized we needed an ongoing effort instead of something new every year. So by then, some of us had friends outside of our Fox Lake neighborhood. We all got together in a living room and brainstormed. How are we going to address this issue? And what came from it was the concept that we would call this project Change for Change. And we were going to ask people to keep their change for a month in the little cups that we would leave in their lower mailboxes.
This is amazing, amazing growth, mm-hmm. And just a little bit of change in a little cup, huh?
Yes.
Edie, talk about the spread to a Sun City South Side.
Right. Well, myself, Edie Torrey, and my co-chair, Peggy Batista, we are the chairmen for the annual springtime campaign called Change for Change. And when we took over as chairman 3 years ago, we had 14 neighborhoods on the north side predominantly. And then what we did was, we, by word of mouth, by being in sensations, by getting the message out, we are now grown into the south side neighborhood, south side of Sun City, and this year we'll have 25 neighborhoods participating, almost 3,600 rooftops.
And Diane, how many families have you reached through this program? I mean, you started out small, but now?
We pack about 200 every month.
And Edie, also, if somebody wants to contact you to either make a donation or, you know, be a help volunteer, what should they do?
Well, they can look, first of all, in Sensations. There's a great article this month in February about us. But we are a registered community group, and they can always reach back in there. Or they can call me directly. My name is Edie Torrey, and my phone number is 203-231-1831.
Congratulations for what you do, and much, much success. When we come back, reporter Sandy Gies interviews Fire Department Assistant Chief Joey Roll. Georgia Lash finds out about Staying Connected Satellite Office. And entertainment reporter Randy Selman was at the Be Wine My Valentine event. So don't go away. We'll return after some important messages from our sponsors. Reporter Sandy Gies had an opportunity to catch up with Fire Department Assistant Chief Joey Roll. Let's listen.
So, Joy, we saw your demonstration at the First Friday. Can you tell us a little bit more about that?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you for having us. And we want to explain to some few of our safety tips at the fire department. One thing that we can do as the fire department is try to prevent fires from happening and also prevent injuries. Some of the most critical life-saving devices that you have are already installed in your home, but a lot of people don't know how to maintain them, what to do with them, and the life expectancy of them. There's a couple of things that we do urge you to do. Smoke alarms, they're very important. They're in your home. We urge you to test them if you can. We urge you to replace the backup battery in those every year. We also encourage you to find out when the smoke alarm was manufactured, because every 10 years they need to be replaced, Bill. But one of the services we do is we will come in and we'll test your smoke alarms for you if you're unable to do so. And with that, we want to make sure that if one goes off, that they all go off.
It's a great service. What else can you tell us about?
Another thing that we need to have in your home is a working fire extinguisher. And as you see here, this is one of the many different sizes and styles of fire extinguishers that you can have for your home. They're not required by code for a residential, but however, they're a very small investment that you can have in your home. And it can sometimes be the difference of property loss or property saved. And sometimes it could be the difference of getting out of a home as well as extinguishing a fire in a home.
So, Joy, I heard about the box that you could put in your garage to aid getting in somebody's house. Can you tell me more about that?
Yes, ma'am. What our fire department has is we have what is called a Knox box system. We have on all commercial structures, and also it goes on residential structures now. And what this is a box that is keyed specifically for our fire department, where if you have an emergency and you're in your home and unable to get to your door, you would contact us as you would do via 911 or whatever. We would get there. We would know that there was a Knox box present on the home, and we would gain access to that box, get your key out, and open the door without having to force entry or break something to try to get in.
How do we get one of those boxes?
You can go to www.knoxbox.com. You can select Hardyville Fire Rescue if you live in the Hardyville jurisdiction. Also, if you live on the Bluffton side, you could select the Bluffton Township Fire Department as the fire department there. And what will happen is it will come in. It comes in unlocked. We would have to physically lock your keys in it for you once you have it mounted.
Oh, that's great. Thank you so much for talking with me today.
Georgia Lash checked with Staying Connected to learn about their satellite office.
I'm with Hugh Armstrong, president of Staying Connected, but we are not in Sun City. Hugh, tell us about this location.
The location we're at right now is at 40 Ocotti Village Drive. It's in the old Bluffton Outpatient Center, Suite 105. And we're here by the grace of Coastal Carolina Hospital, allowing us to use this space.
Hugh, how did it come to the attention of the hospital that this facility was here and that it was made available to you?
Well, this was a room that was being used by Coastal Carolina Hospital as a physical therapy unit, and it wasn't working for them. So we were looking for some additional space. We happened to walk through the building and saw Coastal's name on this door, and they've been a great sponsor, a partner of ours for a long time. So we reached out to the hospital and said, oh, by the way, what are you doing with that space? Could we use it? And they graciously said that we could use it until their lease terminated.
That's great. Now, what are the services that will be conducted in this location?
We use this location, well, pre-COVID for sure. We used it for meetings, for training, and kind of as a business office. COVID changed that a lot, so it's not used as much, but we see it being used quite a bit as we go forward.
Now, how long will you be in this location? Is there any time limit to that?
Right now, if we don't find another way to move the lease forward, this lease terminates at the end of July, and we're working right now to see if we can find a way to retain this space.
Well, I think it shows how much value the community has with Staying Connected to offer you the space, and I hope you'll be able to continue.
Yeah, thank you. It's a great example that we couldn't have put the program together to support the COVID vaccinations without this space, because we had a phone and an office space to work with. And so I think it's a benefit to everyone in the community for us to be able to stay here.
As you are a benefit to us, for sure. Thank you so much for all you do.
Thank you.
Reporter Randy Selman attended the Be Wine My Valentine event at the Lake House on Friday, February 12th.
Nothing says love like a good bottle of wine and a delicious box of chocolate. So I'm here at the Lake House for Be Wine My Valentine. Come on, let's take a look. So Manon, what are you planning on serving today?
Well, we're gonna start out with champagne, Prosecco champagne, and we're gonna have wine, red wine tasting, white wine, and a chittery box.
And what's going to be in the box?
There's going to be different types of cheeses, crackers, and some chocolates.
The chocolates make my mouth water. Well, thank you. I hope you have a great evening, and we're looking forward to it.
Thank you kindly.
Oh, I'll ask again. How long have you been Valentine's?
14 years.
We've been married for 34 years.
34 blissful Valentine-type years?
Absolutely.
7 years.
7 years right here in Sun City.
Oh, let's see, about 30-something years.
About 37 years, Signe?
About 39 years.
Can you think of the most romantic gift that you've ever received?
A trip to Italy.
A trip to Italy? Was it a long trip?
14 days.
He took me to Jamaica one time.
Did you know that you were going?
Yes, but I wasn't expecting the room and the place as well.
Just his dedication and love.
You see, ladies, that's all it takes. Tell your husbands, don't worry about the diamond rings. Don't worry about the new car. Just dedication and love.
He does romantic things all the time, not just for Valentine's Day.
That's the best answer I've gotten all night.
Still more to come on Sun City News. Randy Selman updates you on March events in her entertainment report. And in our News You Can Use segment, we hear from Noah Rosenstein from the Computer Club on tax identity fraud. Doug Wright checks out a women's softball celebration in his sports report. We'll return after some messages from our sponsors. Now let's head over to Randy Selman for an entertainment report.
They say that March comes in as a lion and goes out like a lamb. Well, the events planned for March will keep you roaring with pleasure. Trivia night begins the month's fun on Thursday, March 4th. Test your knowledge and also your companion's knowledge on all your favorite subjects. Don't worry. If you don't know the answer, someone at your table might. I guarantee you'll surprise yourself by how much trivia you actually know. If not, I promise you'll learn something new. The game begins at 6 p.m. in Pickney Hall. Tickets are $5 and available at Lifestyle Services or online. While staying close to home this past year, you might have noticed that some things are in need of redecorating. So here's your chance to gather some ideas and information at the Home and Garden Expo on Saturday, March 6th at and around the Pavilion grounds. Home improvement vendors will be on hand to answer all of your questions. The event runs from 10 a.m. until 2 p.m. On Monday, March 8th and Tuesday, March 9th, both at 6 p.m., Queen Nation will be rocking at the Pavilion. Enjoy the music that will bring you back to the golden age of a vintage Queen concert. Queen Nation strives to emulate and recreate the aura of the original legendary rock band Queen. Tickets are $20 and available at Lifestyle Services or online. Gates and Bar Service opens at 5 p.m. on both evenings. I'm Randy Selman, and that's your entertainment report. Remember, life is entertaining, so be safe, wear a mask, and enjoy the show.
Now let's go to Noah Rosenstein from the Computer Club, who highlights tips dealing with tax identity fraud. Noah?
Tax identity fraud takes place when someone uses a stolen Social Security number to fraudulently file a tax return and collect a tax refund. These scammers usually file claims as early as possible. Victims are unaware of the crime until they try to file a return and learn one has already been filed in their name. Follow these tips to reduce your risk of becoming a victim of tax identity fraud. First, file your taxes early. Scammers take advantage of the fact that many taxpayers wait until late in the tax filing season to file their taxes. Filing as soon as possible gives scammers less time to use your stolen personal information to file a false return. This year, the IRS is accepting returns beginning February 12, 2021. Avoid using public Wi-Fi networks to file. If you and your spouse are filing your return electronically, use a secure internet connection. Use a secure mailbox like the one at the post office. If you and your spouse are filing by mail, send your tax return from the post office instead of your mailbox at home to avoid the possibility of scammers being able to access your mailbox. Select the right tax preparer. If you and your spouse hire someone to do your taxes, do your research and get recommendations before you hand over your financial information. Shred documents you don't need. After you and your spouse file your tax return, shred any documents containing sensitive information if you don't need them anymore. Store any tax documents you need to keep in a safe place. Be aware of phishing, scams by email, text, or phone. Scammers may try to solicit sensitive information by impersonating the IRS. Know that the IRS will not contact you by email, text, or social media. If the IRS needs information, they'll contact you by mail first. And especially if you believe you have been a victim of tax identity theft, alert the IRS Identity Protection Specialized Unit at 800-908-4490. For Tech Talks, I'm Noah Rosenstein on behalf of the Sun City Computer Club. Our club is much more than just computers. We are about communications and technology. We teach how to use this technology to stay connected, entertain, and to learn.
Doug Wright is here with the sports report.
Last week, love was in the air as Valentine's Day approached, and the players in the Peg Welsh Women's Softball League rose to the occasion to thank those men who have been instrumental in developing and promoting the league. Let's take a look at the celebration.
Well, Victoria, you ladies and the gentlemen who support you have just been treated to a wonderful serenade. Who put this together?
It was a team effort. What can I say? So we just decided to, treat them a little bit.
Well, it was an excellent deal. And I might add, you're very late on your feet because this was supposed to happen at the ball field.
I know. I'm very disappointed it didn't happen at the ball field because Mother Nature did not dry her tears early enough to let us on the ball field. So that's the reason why.
And then a few brief words. Tell us what these guys do for you.
Oh, my gosh. Well, when we run our skills and drills, they basically take a group of women and either start hitting balls to them, give them instruction. We have a gentleman who is helping us with scorekeeping. We have another guy who, infield, outfield, scorekeeping, umpiring. So we have like an umpire's corner where we'll provide situations and that are presented to the girls, and they have to tell us what the umpire's call would be. Or if they have a question about one of the umpire's call, the umpires will explain it. So we have a couple umpires that help us out, Bob Black and Wayne Calloway. Ken Absher is also an umpire. Dennis McGuire and John Meckley, of course, coach. Cliff Barthman and Bob Vondersmith, also coach. John Meyer, he helps with scorekeeping. And there's a couple guys who aren't here because they're getting new knees, like Don Schofield and Kevin Thompson. And then there's Jack Schultz, who also takes care of the field. So, and another one of our fans, we have a couple of fans that come out practically every practice and every scrimmage that we have, which is Bob Monty Montgomery and Charlie DeViva with his wife Kathy. So that's what they do for us. They just help encourage us and lift our spirits and just help us be successful.
Well, that's a remarkable recall of names. Way to go. And thanks once again for your time. We wish you all the luck this season. We'll be keeping track.
Nicely done, ladies. Now, put down those electronics and get that body in motion. Doug Wright, Sun City Sports.
That's your news update for this week. Thank you for watching. We invite you to check out Sun City TV's weekly program schedule in SunStations Magazine. And now check highlights and alerts on Twitter at SunCityTVHHI. Also email us at suncitytvhh@gmail.com. To see extended coverage of your favorite news segments, tune in to Extra. Check the current SunStations magazines for daily times. And make sure you tune in next week to find out all the news that's happening in our community. In the meantime, I hope your week is full of only good news. For Sun City News, I'm Norma Taylor, and I'll see you next week.